get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Paddy DuCastan, Richard Dawson. From the Betty White Show, Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Well, thank you, friend. Kind of you to join us here. You're going to have a good time because the loonies are loose. I greet you.
Yeah.
And thank you for showing up. Are you charmed?
Yes.
Certainly you are.
And charming.
You're wearing daisies again, eh, Chuck?
Oh, let her wear her own.
You know, I don't need this job. I have theater jobs.
I know it. Yes, we might as well talk about that right now.
No, I won't even bring it up. I don't need plugs like certain shows that are dying on TV that other people have. And I'll wear a daisy when I want.
In spite of his acerbic attitude.
No, this woman has caused trouble since she's been on the show.
He is directing a Paul Robeson piece starring James Earl Jones. It's The Life of Paul Robeson.
A piece about Paul Robeson.
A piece about Paul Robeson starring James Earl Jones.
Very
and
good.
It's quite good in spite of the fact that he's a louse.
It's playing the country, so go see it.
Yes, it really is good. Now, we have Bill Belcher and Diana Matheson over here. And Bill is the current champ here with $600. And he's being challenged by Diana, who has matched 5 of our celebrities. And when we get back from this commercial, Bill, you got to match 2 to tie, 3 to win. Okay?
Very good.
All right. Good luck to both of you. We'll do that right after this. All right. We shall finish this game. This is the last question, the last round, Bill. 2 to tie, 3 to win. African tribesmen said, The African tribesmen said, let me tell you why I hate dogs. Yesterday, one came up to me and started blanking the bone in my nose. You don't play, you don't play, and you don't play.
Oh,
Nipsey,
God.
Charles, and Betty. The African tribesmen said, let me tell you why I hate dogs.
I know.
Yesterday, one came up to me and started blanking the bone in my nose.
To get letters.
Get it from home.
Yes, of course.
Go figure it out.
It is done.
Done?
That is my job.
Okay, Bill, here it is. The African tribesman said, let me tell you why I hate dogs. Yesterday, one came up to me and started blanking the bone in my nose.
I said, chewing on the bone.
Chewing on the bone in my nose. I think you got a good answer there. You've seen those pictures of the tribesmen? They have the bone in the nose that looks like this. You know, maybe not quite that long, but
we'll
it's...
We'll get spears.
Yes, we'll get spears. Send your spears. Hello.
I've seen something even more savage than a man with a bone in his nose.
What's that?
I've seen a woman with rings in her ears.
Really? And bells on her
face? Burying!
Burying the bone. That's a good one. Now, you must match the 2 remaining one, Bills, to achieve a tie. And they are Charles...
I also said burying.
Burying, so that means Diana Matheson wins the game. What do you have? She said chewing over there. You got 1 out of 3. Congratulations, my dear. Over there, please. Well, sir, you got $600, and that'll get you home, won't it?
It will.
Thank you for coming up here, Bill, and playing Match Game 77. Bill Belcher, ladies and gentlemen. There he goes. There he goes. Now, Diana, this is all for you. We'd turn down all that electricity just to swing this thing around so you could play a little game here and win a lot of money. Did the light go out somewhere? Seems a little darker in here. Okay. Diana, not too long ago, we polled a studio audience and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Thank you for turning the lights back on again. Blank Russell. Blank Russell. Now, the answer that group wrote most frequently is valuable to you. It'll get you $500 if you match it. If you match their second most popular answer, you get $250. And then for matching the third, you get 100, and 3 of our 6 celebrities will help you.
Richard.
I'm going to mention a name right now. I know we'll get me stairs. But watch my hand. I'll point him there. He lives right upstairs.
Good old Nipsey.
Nipsey Russell.
Betty. Rosalind Russell.
Rosalind Russell?
Patty.
Oh, dear, I have to make a choice.
Number one.
Jane Russell.
Jane Russell.
So, my first wife.
Jane Russell, Nipsey Russell, and Rosalind Russell. Now, it's your option at this time to choose one of those three or give us one of your own. You might think it over here and come up with a better one. What do you say?
Has to be Nipsey.
Yeah. Has to be Nipsey. All right. I dare say Nipsey will be up there somewhere.
Oh, I'm always around somewhere.
All right, let's find out if Nipsey Russell is hiding in that pile someplace. May we see the $100 response? Bill Russell, the basketball player.
Yeah. All right, let's me out.
No, you can be up there, Nipsey. Let me see the $250 response. Nipsey Russell.
There you go. Oh. You are famous,
Nipsey. How about that?
You are famous. Who do you think's on top? Jane or Lillian?
Jane, all right.
Jane. All right, may we see it, please? Jane it is.
Yeah.
Jane Russell, okay. Now you've
surprise,
got
I thought Russell.
An opportunity to win $2,500 here, which is 10 times the amount you just won. And to collect, you got to match one celebrity.
Richard.
All right, good luck to you. Get your ESP going over to him, and you're going to win this money. $2,500. Ready over there?
Ready.
Here we go. Blank parent. P-A-R-E-N-T. Blank parent. Blank parent. Blank parent. Diana, he's made up his mind. We ask you to make up your mind now. Blank parent. What do you say to that?
Single parent.
Oh. Who's that who's holding his head down there? He says, oh, no. Who's that?
I don't see anybody holding their head down.
Who's that fellow in the first row with the mustache?
I don't know.
You didn't like that answer, sir? All right, he didn't like that answer. Single parent is what she says. Richard will match it and give her the $2,500.
I got a feeling you wanted grandparent, didn't you? Is that what
grandparent.
You
said? You wanted grandparent? Is that what you wanted
is
down
that
there?
What
grandparent.
Of course, it's really nothing to do with you, is it? It's between this lady and me.
I want to know who wrote that line, Zoe. Listen, where is it? Where's the... Oh, the time change. Oh, I thought you wanted... Listen, beginning November 7th, that's not too long from now. When is that? Next week. November 7th is about next week, somewhere
it's
in there.
It's October the 21st today, Jim.
It's October the 21st, so it's in a couple of weeks, week after next, as a matter of fact. CBS is changing our time from this present time till 11 a.m. Eastern time, 10 a.m. Midwestern and Western time. It's the same network and all that, and it's going to be the same wacky show with a new time. 11 a.m. in the East, 10 a.m. in the West and Midwest, and we hope those of you watching now will be...
Yeah, because we follow the Price is Right, right?
Oh, we follow the Price is Right. So you just turn it on in the morning and just roll along with CBS all day. Now let's all say hello to Honey Lynn.
Oh.
Honey Lynn.
Fine, thank you.
Where's Honey Lynn from?
Long Beach, California.
What do you do?
I'm a substitute teacher, but I'm currently working for my dad in his office as his receptionist and insurance girl.
Uh-huh. An insurance person, we say now.
Okay.
You want to say that?
Insurance person.
Okay. Anything you say is all right with me, Honey Lynn. That's a darling name. Honey
Lynn.
Thank you. Yes. Anything else you want to say?
In my spare time, I enjoy traveling and I like to paint.
Are you an abstract expressionist?
No, I paint on jeans and...
Oh.
I don't do it.
Jeans.
All right.
Men and women.
You can paint this jean anytime you want.
Body painting.
Okay. Honey Lynn, honey, you may have A or B.
B.
B it is. You got it. Ready?
We're always ready.
On the safari, Joe said... I think I've gotten rid of my rotten wife. I just saw blank wearing her earrings. He uttered those words while he was on the safari.
I think I've gotten rid of my rotten wife. I just saw blank wearing her earring.
I wish to register a protest.
Why?
I'm sick of those boys always writing about rotten wives. I want a female writer on here.
Okay.
Writing about rotten husbands. About her rotten wife.
On the safari.
I want to move. I'm sure. I've had 5 years of this, and I just want to sit on a chair someplace else. The rug is plenty big enough. I can put my chair anyplace.
On the safari.
Why doesn't she go on one?
Sure. On the safari, Josephine said.
Better.
I think I've gotten rid of my rotten husband. I just saw blank wearing his earrings. See, that
very
doesn't
good.
Work right.
It's all right. Don't worry.
Cufflinks, yeah.
It'll track.
Ready?
No.
No. You ready?
I'm finished, and I have to give a speech.
Well, we're going to start without him, honey, Lynn. Here we go. On the safari, Joe said, I think I've gotten rid of my rotten wife. I just saw a blank wearing her earrings.
Cannibal.
A cannibal. All right. What comes to mind, Nipsey?
Well, what comes to mind is the cannibal who said to his wife, I don't like your mother. She said, well, just eat the vegetables.
Cannibal is one. Honey Lynn? What does the head of the Los Angeles chapter of Women's Lib have to say?
My indignant speech rushed the blood to my brain, and I got the answer right. Cannibal.
Cannibal. Super Honey Lynn.
I don't know what this is. I said a native guide stretcher bearer.
A native guide stretcher bearer.
Just that's a cannibal.
A native guide stretcher bearer. It could be a cannibal. It also could be a native who is not addicted to eating the
human
dairy.
What do you say, Patty?
Well, I thought on safaris you saw a lot of lions.
Lions, yes. Yeah.
With earrings?
With earrings, you would look wonderful.
All that wonderful hair.
Yeah.
Watch my lion.
Yeah, I said a native.
A native, yes. Native could or could not be a cannibal. What do you say, Betty?
Cannibalis horribilis.
Cannibalis. All right. That's three for Honey Lynn. Now, Diana, we've got this one for you. Hey, did you hear about the dumb robber?
No.
No, how dumb was he?
I'll tell you about this dumb robber. He tried to rob a blank bank.
He did.
That's how dumb he was.
Got it.
What is it?
A dumb robber tried to rob
a blank bank.
There are two terrific answers.
Yes, there are indeed.
I'd like to give both.
Neither one of which
I may.
You can think of.
Okay.
Or not, give one.
Here we go, Diana. This dumb robber. Have you heard about him? He tried to rob a blank bank.
A blood bank.
Blood bank. She said blood bank.
Yeah, I had thought eye bank, but she's right. Blood bank.
Blood bank is good. Have you got one of the terrific answers?
Sure. Blood.
Okay, that's two for her.
Blood.
Blood. Wonderful, wonderful blood. Oh, I love blood. It is wonderful. Wonderful to drink a pint of blood every night before I go to sleep. What do you say?
Blah.
Blah. Give us some blood.
I love it when you do, Mr. Periwinkle.
Blood.
Show us your blood.
Blood.
Blood. Got all six. Well, you got some catching up to do, but right now we've got this to do, especially for you. We're ready to carry on here. Go to the second and final round and ask Honey Lynn to make a selection.
B.
You've got it, honey. Three people play. Honey, you've got to match the three remaining ones you have not matched in order to achieve a tie and stay in the game. They are these two and that one up there. Fat Frida has the most unusual job in the library. They use her blanks as bookends.
Yeah, you see?
I want that changed to Fat Fred.
Fat Fred.
They use his blanks.
Has the most unusual job in the library.
No, you don't,
no,
Fred.
No, you can't. It won't work. I'm sorry.
Yes, it would.
Fat Frida, the most unusual job in the library. They use her blanks as bookends.
Don't make fun of that. I like them that way.
Ready, Chuck?
Chuck.
Here, Chuck.
Here, Chuck.
He's ready.
He needs a moment more.
Honey, Fat Frida has the most unusual job in the library. They use her blanks as bookends.
Her arms.
Oh! Well, then, what do
Honey.
You want the poor lady to say?
You ever watch this show?
Yes.
You ever heard that word before that the audience is screaming at you?
Yes.
I see. Well, she said arms. You got to match all three of them to stay in the game, honey. Charles, what do you say?
Very large boo.
Boo. Does that mean Diantha wins the game? And boobs there. Boobs, honey. There you go. Right there. Thank you, my dear. Honey, we've got some gifts for you, together with our thanks for being here on Match Game 77. Honey Lynn,
Thank
ladies
you.
And gentlemen.
Thank
Bye.
You.
Okay. I remember you. You've been here before. You know how this goes. We'll get right to it. We had a whole bunch in the studio audience, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank laundry. Now, the answer they gave most often, remember, will get you $500 if you match it. If you match the second one, you get $250. And for matching the third, you get $100, and three of our six celebrities will help you.
Richard.
Dirty.
Dirty laundry is one.
Nipsey.
What's that?
What's that? It's a thing, blank laundry.
Well, since it is an enterprise in which that particular ethnic group involves itself, I would say Chinese laundry.
Chinese laundry.
Betty.
Clean laundry.
What is that?
I didn't say anything. I was just clearing my throat.
French. French.
Here, Susan.
Oh, wait, I'm getting a message.
Yeah, think of,
I
think
will say, of. I'm getting a message. Hand laundry.
Hand laundry. Okay, so you have hand laundry, dirty laundry, and Chinese laundry. You want one of those or one of your own?
I think I'll take dirty.
Dirty laundry? That was the one that Richard gave you. We'll find out. If there's any dirty laundry in the building, may we see the $100 number? Coin laundry.
Coin laundry. Oh,
all
right.
They have those. Do-it-yourself type places. May we see the $250 number? Dirty it is. You've got it. Congratulations. You pick up another $250. You have $3,200 to your credit now. What do you think is on top?
Chinese.
All right. May we see it, please? Aha. So. You have no faith in our audience, do you?
Confucius, eh?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, why didn't you say Chinese then?
I thought they liked dirty better.
Oh,
but
this bunch likes dirty, but they don't. Now, we're going to give you that money, $2,500, if you'll match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
Okay, here we go. Face me if you would, please. It's worth $2,500. Good luck to you, and this is it. Blank pencil. Blank pencil. All right. Here it is now. Worth $2,500 to you, Diana. Good luck to you. Blank pencil.
Sharp pencil?
Sharp pencil is what she says will match you, Richard. For $2,500, what do you say?
There's lead pencil, blue pencil. I said pen and pencil.
Pen and pencil is a good answer. Sharp pencil is good. There are a number of good ones there. You both did very well with it. And you picked up a little more money. You got $3,200, Diana, and we've got this for you. Listen, you were all splendid.
Well, thank you, Diana.
And I am deeply in your debt. And if there's something I can do for any of you right now to show my appreciation and
give me
thanks,
a couple of bucks.
I see.
I've already made the reservation.
Tell me who'll be here next time.
I will tell you next time when you join us. These are the people you'll see.
Bob Barker, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ava Gabor, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Beaubois.
Join us next time for Match Game 77. Jim Raven here. Goodbye.